So on my last Rumble video, I got a comment expressing some disappointment that I don't actually use the onboard overdrive, and since I've never really messed with it, I thought this would be a good opportunity to see what I'm missing out on, if anything. Something that I've been doing lately that I've been really enjoying is trying to copy like specific tones from famous songs, so that's what I'm gonna try today, starting with my favorite band, Queens of the Stone Age. When I started playing around with the distortion on this thing, this was the first tone I heard. It's the auditory equivalent of a big, slobbery, mean dog with a spike collar like pulling against his chain. It just sounds mean. Now the vintage button on the Rumble definitely helps with that low end grunt, but I feel like the real key to this tone is dialing in just the right amount of tone knob. If you go too far with it, it just gets muddy, but too much the other way and then it sounds really harsh. The other thing you probably noticed is how ugly this sound is by itself. It's really not that pleasant. Something that takes a while as a bassist is to learn how to make your sound blend with the band. The tone that sounds good when you're at home by yourself doesn't always translate when you take it to the rehearsal or to the gig. If you're in a loud wall of sound style band like Queens of the Stone Age, you're gonna have to dial in a lot of mids to not get drowned out by all the guitars. That said though, let's take this in the opposite direction now and let's do funk. I love this song by Jamiroquai because it's one of the few that I can think of that features slapping on a P bass. It's just so unique and spanky. Now, when I was trying to copy this tone, the thing that makes it work is the contour button, which essentially makes a little smiley face out of the EQ, bumping up the bass and the treble and scooping the mids. Now, while this sound is great for funk slapping where you've just got lots of room in the mix, it's not something that I would use outside of that. There's kind of this running joke among bass players that you're never loud enough, but a part of that is that you're not EQing correctly. When you scoop out the mids, your remaining frequencies are competing with where the guitar would be playing the lower chords. In funk music, they tend to be playing higher up, so then you've got a little bit more room in that area. Generally speaking, the low mids is where your tone lives, so don't overlook that. So now, let's take a small jump from funk to Chili Peppers, and let's just add some overdrive in there for fun. The intro to Around the World is so iconic. It's just so bombastic and tasty and memorable, which is crazy because it only lasts like 20 seconds. This does, however, bring me to the main reason that I don't use the onboard overdrive very often. Cause like, what do you do when you get to the clean part? Are you gonna like walk over to the amp and turn it off with your hand? No, of course not. Now to their credit, Fender does sell a pretty reasonably priced foot switch just for this purpose, but I don't really see myself wanting to run an extra cable to my already crowded pedal board. I already have a big spaghetti mess on stage and I don't need more complexity. All right, let's do one more. I'm gonna cap this off with the legendary Tim Commerford.
Draw the same that burn crosses.
So the tricky thing about Tim's tone is that he's bi-amping, which is kind of a hard feel to make with just a single amp. He has one head set up for his clean tone and then a second head set up for his overdrive. But he's not switching the clean head off when he kicks on the overdrive. So then you get this stacked sound of the two running together, and it sounds absolutely massive. The big advantage to doing this is that you don't ever sacrifice your fundamental. Like, your clean tone has all of this presence and punch, but then you get the aggression on top of it, and then when you blend them together, you get the best of both worlds. There's so much high-end clank in all of this, so what I ended up doing was bumping just a little bit of the treble control on the amp, turning on the bright switch on the tone controls, but also turning up the treble control on the bass. Which is crazy to me because the Stingray is already a bright sounding bass. But hey, you can't argue with the results. I'm wanting to delve deeper into really accurately getting Tim's tone, but doing it in Logic instead, where I'd have more options to have both of the amps represented. If that's something you're interested in seeing, be sure to subscribe because I'm actively working on that right now. Anyway, I gotta go get my trees fed, so I will see you on the next one.